What is going on, my mates? May vlog number 20. Happy Tuesday. Hope you're freaking doing well. We're about to get some gas. And then we about to do it. Alrighty, my mates, we got the gas. We're ready to go. I'm not gonna waste your time. We're just gonna jump right into this track by track review of the new Story So Far album, Proper Dose. Comes out this Friday. It's freaking great. Spoiler alert, I'm not gonna ask for your subscription right now, but if at the end of this video you feel entertained or informed or just enjoyed it, I ask that you click subscribe. So thank you all so much. Let's get into this. Sorry, one more thing. I did make a video about this just generally talking about the album, so I'll link that below and like put it right here or something. So if you wanna check that out, go ahead and check that out too if you like. I will give each song 1 to 5 stars and then take the average out of all the songs, and then that will be our rating for the album. Proper Dose, the title track for this album, is the opener. It's fast, it's catchy, it's only like 2 minutes, but you're gonna freaking love it. It's so good. This is just the best possible opener. I can't say enough good things about this. You're gonna love it when you hear it, but this one's 5 out of 5 for me, for sure. Next, we have Keep This Up, and this track is good. I do wanna start by saying it is a good track, but compared to the rest of the songs on this album, it just doesn't quite stack up. It's rather forgettable, but overall, it's a good song, man. I have to give this 3.5 out of 5 stars because it is rather forgettable. Followed up by that is their track Out of It that they released freaking like a year ago now as a single, but they re-recorded it for this album. Oh, it sounds so freaking good. It is like honestly one of my favorite songs that they've ever made. It's so catchy. It's fast. It's got like a mix of their previous 3 albums. It is so good. You've already heard the song, but the remixed, like kind of more produced version is just so good. 5 out of 5 stars, freaking easy. Take Me As You Please is the 4th track on this album. I did think that it was a good track. It's one of their slower songs. It has kind of a clairvoyant navy blue type of vibe to it. But the more I listened to it, the more it just felt kind of average, not super great. I mean, it is a good song. I will say it's a good song. It's just not my favorite on the album. I'm gonna have to give this one 3.5 out of 5 stars. It is a good track. It's just not my absolute favorite on the album. Track number 5 is called Let It Go. This is the first single that they released that wasn't Out of It, because they released Out of It like a year like ago, and then this is their first single that they released after that like a couple months ago, and I thought the song was really good. It's really catchy. It's kind of like medium paced. It's like kind of acoustic-y, but kind of like Parker's still yelling, so it's really good. It has a really good chorus. It's like, go! I would say this is definitely a 4 out of 5 track. This is one of the better songs on this album. Oh, track 6, Upside Down, is literally one of my favorite songs that the Story So Far has ever written. I think it's one of the saddest songs, the best songs, the catchiest songs. So I think it goes without saying that's a 5 out of 5. This genuinely might be my favorite song that they've ever put out. But before I make that claim, I'm just gonna let this whole album sink in. But right now, I'd say it's my favorite song they've ever put out. Next track, If I Fall, is quite a good track, if I do say so myself. It's just, I think what really sold me on this track was the guitar work. It's like, it just sounded so cool. It sounds like they're experimenting a little. I love it. I love the sound. I love that they're willing to experiment. So I'd have to give this one a 4 out of 5. Need to Know is a song that I thought was going to be a little bit forgettable at first, one that I was going to have to give a lower rating to. But as I was listening to it towards the end, there's this, I don't know if you'd call it a chorus. Towards the end of the song, there's this part where Parker goes, "Save Moss." And he says it way cooler than that. It really makes the song, to be honest, just from my perspective, obviously. But I'd have to give this one a 4 out of 5 stars as well. All right, number 9. Is called Line, and I honestly really didn't like it very much. It was very slow. It felt kind of filler. I didn't think it was very good at all. This is the lowest rating of the entire album, and it's a 3 out of 5. Growing on You is quite the song. There's this one part in the song that says, "Are you leaving me now for the high that you chase?" And I was just like, drugs are just so destructive, my mates. Just don't do drugs at all. This song is a 4 out of 5. It's really solid. Just, I think you're gonna like it. And we close this album out with track 11, Lightyear. It kind of wraps up the entire album. Parker's like, "Yo, how did I get here, man?" Like, I think he literally says that. Got a good sound to it. Kind of has a closing type of vibe. Like, "Hey, man, we're wrapping this up, but we're going to keep it kind of full of energy and everything." I'd have to give this one a 4 out of 5 as well. So when you total this up, you get 45 out of 45 stars based on my rating. Buy that down to a percent. It is an 81%. So 81 out of 100. I honestly think the album might even be a little bit higher than that. But it's definitely overall a 4 out of 5. Thank you all so much for tuning into this and saying what's up and supporting the channel. Once again, if you thought this video was entertaining, valuable, if you were informed or just liked it, make sure to hit subscribe because we're growing faster than ever. It's really blowing my mind. But thank you, mates, so much, and I will catch you